Hey everyone, this is Darkfire Slide here with a replay of Company of Heroes 2. I've been wanting to actually do replays of Company of Heroes 2 for a while, but I wasn't sure if Sega was okay with like monetizing their videos, or more specifically Relic, I guess, since they're the actual developer of the game. But anyway, I am joined by El Conquistador de Amor, also known as Kothra from one of my other videos. We're going double Wehrmacht against a US player and a Soviet player. And
So hello all.
anyway, let's get this started, Conquistador.
Right, let's do it. Do you want me to do the countdowns?
Oh yeah, sure.
Alrighty. Three, two, one.
All right.
Alrighty.
So, I really enjoyed this game, and there were a variety of reasons for that, and chief among them is some of the really interesting tactics that the Soviet player here.
Yes, on multiple occasions I almost alt F4'd in this game. I was getting very salty at certain points in this match, I will admit.
Yeah, I'll try to zoom to some of those wonderful things that happened. But yes, to introduce our opponents here, we are joined by Barry Harvestasia. I have no idea if I'm pronouncing that right. Probably not. From the Fog, and the FOG clan. Probably just a Steam tag for something. Probably another game. And then also we are facing off against the player Chameleon from the R22R clan. And yeah, pretty standard opening from the Soviet player thus far, but it gets interesting in a couple of minutes here. I personally am going for two grands into MG, and Conquistador, you're actually opening with a M like grand MG and then grand, right?
Yeah, because I don't know, I just had a feeling I was going to be fighting the American player, and American players tend to blob a lot more. So I was like, I think I'm just going to take my chances, kind of lock down an area with an MG, and then go off capping after I've at least gotten the flank secured. For the
Right.
most part, it kind of worked.
Yeah, I think so too, and I think you did a really good job, like guessing that the American player was going to be on your side for sure.
Yeah, thankfully I was actually right about that.
Yeah. And I wish, like, I think personally, my favorite opening is triple grand into MG,
Also a very respectable strategy.
because it has a lot more offensive flexibility in the early game, which really tends to throw off allied players, I've found. Especially if you do a doctrine that gets like G43s or something. And that's just my opinion on that. But anyway, we've let's see. I keep waiting for it, and basically what the Soviet player does, he actually builds a second engineer squad at one point. But starting out, we've actually got this engagement here at the fuel point, and this entire match, I was basically just fighting for this fuel point. And it was actually like a hell of a lot of fun doing it, and it was like a super interesting from like a tactical perspective. Because the thing is, the Soviet player kept throwing curveballs at me just time and time again. But I love what happens here. The pioneer flank is enough to send his conscripts running for the hills, as it were, as Conquistador sends in another
Yeah,
engineer
everybody
squad.
miss everybody underestimates the pioneer flank.
They can do a surprising amount of damage, especially to
I
scripts if
mean,
they're
yeah.
not prepared.
They're like mini assault grenadiers.
Yeah, and as we can see here on Conquistador's side of the map, got a armor company opening from the US player, which is always more interesting, I think. It gives you a lot more flexibility as a US player, in my opinion, when you open with that. Since assault engineers are actually really strong now, I feel like. They're a unit that's definitely grown on me as they've been buffed through patches and whatnot. Got some fighting over here by the middle VP with these penals and these grands.
Yeah, I'm trying to move my grenadiers back because flamethrowers, as some of you might not know, actually have a bonus against units in cover. So I just wanted to maintain my range instead of sitting behind that green cover by that truck.
Yeah, yeah, and this Soviet player was really effective at using his penals to kind of push us back, and those flamethrowers really did take a toll on us, I think. I know on me at least, it pushed me back more than just a few times.
Yeah, the American player did a good job of keeping me back too in the early game.
Yeah, he And I mean, this is about what you should, you know, expect from a American opening. This is how you should definitely be playing for an American opening. And I will give it to these guys. They had very good micro of their infantry for the most part. Though we do get a squad wipe there pretty early.
I lost a lot of squads this game, too.
Yeah, I actually don't remember that rifle squad getting wiped right there.
Well, you were fighting the Soviet most of the time.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I did send a squad over to that western capture point. We're going to take the munitions point. One thing I've been kind of theory crafting lately is I think munitions are actually kind of more important in the early game for Wehrmacht than fuel. Until you have enough munitions to get all of your grins kitted with MGs and G43s if you've got them in a doctrine, I think munitions are definitely just more important for being able to hold off the early game of the Allied factions.
I would agree to that to an extent. I think it's very important to have the munitions. Oh, I don't think it'd be worth giving up both fuels for. I think it'd be worth giving up maybe one of the fuels.
Oh, definitely not giving up both fuels, but definitely you want to have at least one munitions point.
Absolutely.
Yeah, to having one of each would be ideal if you can't get more than that.
Mm-hmm.
Because having those munitions ability, those abilities, even... And that's actually one of the things that comes up in this game a lot, is I'm actually going to the Festung Armor doctrine, kind of trying to break the meta a little bit, not use a doctrine with a tiger call in. And
I unfortunately am not such a hipster.
I don't really, unfortunately, I don't really use much of the abilities from the doctrine the entire game, except for the first one that you get, Panzer Tactician, which is frankly becoming one of my favorite abilities like in the game, just like period. Conceptually, I really like Festung Armor, actually. Like the ability, just having a bunch of defensive abilities for your tanks. Which is just really strong, I think, for Wehrmacht, once you start getting those Panzer IVs out. Which, honestly, is my favorite medium tank in the game right now. Just because it's non-doctrinal and it's so effective, you know, at what it does and against the armor it goes against, usually. But yeah, we actually get some pretty good map control here around 6 minutes, 7 minutes. And this is not the position you want to be in when you're an allied player. As an allied player, you always want to be ahead, you always want to be attacking, you really want to be taking the map more. That being said, it is still the early game, and this part right here near the VP in the middle, we actually start getting pushed back a lot, and that's because these penals really do a good job.
People underestimate them, that's for sure. They're actually pretty good units, honest.
If you can get a group of them, you know, maybe even just one squad, they're very effective at pushing Grens without MGs back. And even if they do have MGs, if you run towards them, you can usually beat them in a one-on-one fight if you can get that flamethrower in range.
Oh, and I just lost my first Gren squad to a demolition charge in the west. I don't know if Darkfire Slide captured that in his stream here, but... I lost many more throughout the rest of the match.
Oh, yeah. That
remember how
me.
I said I almost rage quit? That's why. I lost a lot of squads to that.
I can't remember for the life of me when these actually happened for the most part. But, man, so many times during this match, we get blown up by demo charges. And that's what I was saying about like the interesting choice of this Soviet player. He actually builds a second engineer squad after he gets a sniper up.
Right, I actually just saw the assault engineer from the American player also planning demo charges, so it was both of them, I'm assuming.
Yeah, and I don't know if these guys were actually like coordinating and communicating amongst themselves, but yeah, there were a lot of demolition charges these matches. If you're an allied player, I would definitely say to try this strategy out. Even though we almost rage quit from doing it.
Please don't play like this online if I'm Axis.
Yeah. don't do it to me, but it is a good strategy. And one thing I was really self-conscious about watching this replay, I kind of just left this MG sitting at the back of the fuel point. And really, I might have been better disposed to have built like a bunker or something back here and have that be an MG. Because the thing is, if you have really good MG micro... as Axis, you can get away with a lot of stuff and really hurt the Allies early game, I think. But it is a bit more difficult to use the MG for that purpose. But that being said, I did build a half track this game, which is definitely not something I see a lot of Wehrmacht players do when I'm playing. But when I knew we were going to be going against a Soviet player, I suspected they might have snipers. And half-tracks, I think, are extremely effective in dealing with snipers, not just because of the half-track itself, which can obviously chase them down, but because the half-track itself can reinforce the troops to get sniped. Unfortunately, I do get a grenadier squad wiped here, which sucks, obviously, but... yeah, I'm actually really low on troops at this point. They outnumber us in squads by quite a...
The American player is starting to get light vehicles as well. He's got an anti-air half-traganda utility car out right now, really investing his fuel into the light vehicles, which really prevented me from from pushing out westward. That and the fear of demolition charges instantly gibbing all of my squads. I was really locked between the points like right next to my base for the most part until I got a tank out.
Oh yeah, but I do love this cutoff you have here at 10 minutes. On this fuel point.
They actually took a while to cap that back too, which is pretty funny.
Oh yeah, that's right. I remember that. I remember sitting there during the match being like, you know, wow, that's really taking them a long time.
Almost
get one of their snipers here. Mm-hmm. At the fuel point, which is pretty great. Going double sniper is a really like risky strategy, I think.
Much better if you have guards to guard them.
Yeah, guard sniper is good. Snipers without guards, it's a little more iffy. But I get extremely lucky here with my half track, which almost gets destroyed. But almost is not, you know, actually happening. So the half track is still alive, and actually will be like I think honestly the critical unit that actually won me the match here. Because with it, I actually do a lot more damage than the Panzer IVs that I will get out later. Now, at this point, they're actually starting to push us back, and this is the mid-game. And the thing is, I think the Allies also, like, not just the early game, but also, like, a really strong mid-game as well. As they start to push us back and get their territories back. I do some really cheesy things this game. At one point, I actually start capping this fuel point with a pack because I don't have any more infantry in the area that's like to do that with.
Yeah, speaking of capping, they still have not capped that fuel up.
Oh yeah,
up north.
It's been like 2 minutes and they still haven't taken
it. Yeah, I was
just
trying to be annoying. I didn't think they were gonna leave it that way.
Yeah. I think of the two, the American player definitely was weaker than the Soviet player.
I would argue that in the late game, definitely, he did do a good job keeping me out of his territory in the beginning, especially because of the demo charges. Yeah, that was
Yep. I actually saw that one. There goes another Gren squad.
He was a very annoying opponent to fight early game. I will definitely grant him that.
Yeah, that's something I didn't even consider, that assault engineers can actually build those, which is another thing that just makes that unit extremely potent, I would say. Because that doesn't just like affect infantry like that. It also rips apart armor.
Mm-hmm.
If you can pull it off, put it on like a road or something. American player putting up a very stalwart defense here. Around this time, I was actually pretty concerned that we were going to lose. They had both the fuel point. Well, that's the interesting thing. He still hasn't capped back that fuel. It's been 3 minutes since Conquistador uncapped it, and they still haven't taken that fuel point back. So really, what I thought was an advantage the entire match really wasn't. They sincerely like handicapped themselves by not taking that fuel point back 3 minutes in. It might even be longer than that. I don't know how long it actually took them to take it back.
I don't remember. Guess we'll find out. Cause, yeah, it's funny. It also cuts off the extra point that they have to the west. So that's actually 10 fuel per minute they're not getting.
Yeah, exactly. And I make a push here into the middle. I kind of regret it. My Grens were not really up to dealing with that push. But then there's a kind of a combined push with these snipers and these light vehicles here in the middle VP. I do something really risky here though, and this is something that I really love about being able to build the half track, like as an option. It'll happen soon, but anyway, yeah. Here I am capping the capping the fuel point with a pack, of all things. And here's the thing: if your opponent's not watching you, you can get away with stuff like this. You know, if you need a pack to capture something, you use a pack to capture something. But anyway, here's why I think the half track won me the match. Every time my units would just get damaged like this, I just
Look in the west. Look in the west right now. That west point. This is where I got faked out the demo charge. You see my grenadiers dancing around it.
Yeah, yeah. that was a great dodge.
Yeah, I only lost one model to it too.
That's amazing, and that's really gonna help you push back these like this lieutenant and this captain here. Meanwhile, I'm pushing back to take back this cutoff point. I got a Vet 3 Gren squad. I think they get wiped. I think. I lose most of my squads in this match, which is, you know, really, like, another reason I was really concerned about our chances in this one. But, okay, right here.
I lost an embarrassing amount as well.
Right here in the middle VP, I do a really risky strat here. I drive in my half track, and I'm like, ah, shit, you know, there's the flak track. But here's the funny thing. He retreats literally everything he's got. I then throw up the Panzer Tactician smoke. He moves back his AT gun, doesn't redeploy it to shoot my half track, and my half track gets away scot-free, basically while causing all of his troops to rout. So that's the kind of stuff, and you can do that with scout cars too, because scout cars also get that ability, though, you know, they are a lot flimsier than half tracks are. I really should probably have not been able to get away with that, but I did, because I don't think it was anything that they were actually expecting. And then, of course, you always want to have a pack, and preferably like an MG if yours hasn't been wiped yet, to get it back there. But anyway, I've got a Panzer IV up now. I'm feeling a little better about our chances at this point, though, while being completely aware that you know, they're gonna have armor out.
Yeah, if you look, we actually only have 3 armor per minute, or sorry, 3 fuel per minute less than they do.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
So we're actually not that far behind, all things considered.
Have they taken that point back yet? Okay, yeah, they've
taken... Yeah, they have it now.
Okay, so it took them almost like 4 or 5 minutes to take that fuel back, and that...
Yeah, that definitely set them back.
Oh, yeah. All right, and here's a round where penals stop being useful, once Grands start getting vet and have MG42s. And another missed micro on my part here. I had the ability to hold down this Panzer IV, but I didn't. I just kind of let it sit there. Because, honestly, I'm not used to using this doctrine, you know,
easy to forget.
Oh, yeah, well, I almost always use, assault support, because it's the only Tiger doctrine I actually own, and, man, those snipers were just a constant thorn in my side the entire game, but the thing is with snipers, you have to be aggressive if you want to take care of them. And the thing is, he was very hesitant with his snipers when he saw that Panzer IV, and that's not something I would have done. Because I don't think the Panzer IV would have wiped. I probably could have wiped that Vet 3 Gren squad with those snipers, which is like something that the Panzer IV wouldn't have been able to deal with by itself. Like the snipers would have gotten away, and I would have been down a squad.
Okay, now I finally pulled out my Panzer IV. You know, here in the west, I actually managed to start taking some territory back. Now that he doesn't have any answers to my tank, really allows me to take the initiative back, which is a godsend for me.
But he does get a Wolverine out.
He does, but he really does miss micro it, as you'll see soon.
Oh yeah, this is and this was really like the turning point in the match. I think the Allies still had the lead at this point, but they definitely were not very good with their tank micro. Even their tank positioning was pretty off. But oh, I love this flank I do here, and this is another reason that the half track I think ended up winning me the match. I send this half track around back behind like his AT gun, get those Grens out, and now we're behind the AT gun. My Panzer IV is safe. As we he brings it around, he's really desperately trying to shoot that half track, but 2 Gren squads and a half track are more than enough to take care of that. The half track MG, once you get it to vet like 2, is actually pretty potent, and oh wow, we've got a really interesting engagement going on over here in the west as well, taking out that half track. Mm-hmm. Really weird choice by the Allied player to build the
he left it right in front of my half track right in front of my pack, allowing me to 2-shot it instead of moving it out of the way for last shot. So it's a godsend for me.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. I don't know why this Soviet player got out a T-70. That's not something I would have done. I probably would have paid for a T-34-76, which, while not a great unit, is armor of some kind.
Yeah, it's at least capable of killing a Panzer IV.
Yeah, or chasing down and killing, like, this half-track, but, right. You know, instead he got the T-70, which is very, very much a micro-intensive unit, to say the least. And around here, we can see that, like, yeah, Conquistador especially is really starting to have another counterattack. And once again, capping with the pack because I can. Now he's gonna sit there with his penals, but I'll just, you know, send in grins from the side. And that's the thing. Flanking is extremely important in COH, I think. It's definitely, like not enough people do it. A lot of people like to just blob, send all their troops in one massive line. But if you split up your forces and attack from multiple directions, especially if they're behind cover, you know.
And as Yoda would say, that is why they fail.
Of course. these snipers are here again. And, I think, man, is that Panzer IV almost done? Does this almost happen? No. It's a little bit more. But basically, I get my vengeance. Now, and this is really surreal. My pack actually starts to get away. Kind of just slide it away here. And then he takes it. Or, sorry, he takes it out, rather. He doesn't take it, which, to me was, you know, really interesting. But then again, I don't know, he had a lot of troops at this point in time. Here's the thing, even if your opponent has a tank up like this, you can still be a little bit aggressive. Like, this half track really is, like I think, a really underrated unit in the meta, especially if you have a Panzer Tactician, because you can just constantly be throwing up, like these smokes to stop them from killing it.
And, did you throw that half track up there just to put a smoke screen on?
Yeah, actually. Also, their snipers were up there, and I wanted to kill them as well. Also, my Grens can reinforce off of it while we're there. But anyway, this Panzer IV, taking out the T-70. I don't destroy it.
I remember this part. If you look in the west on the munitions point, I had minesweepers, so I could see that demo charge sitting there, and I had my Panzer IV shooting, attacking ground on it, and it would keep missing, so I just get mad and rifle-nade it.
Nice.
Waste munitions on that.
I kind of missed it a little bit, but basically my Panzer IV went forward and completely took out these snipers here. Or one of the sniper squads just completely wiped it. He gets an IS-2 out, and again, using the Panzer Tactician, letting my Panzer IV get away without the IS-2 knowing which direction he's going to go in. Half-track just, you know, crawling backwards to try to get into a safer position. And right around here, the Soviet player, he hesitates. He waits for his infantry to get up there, which is smart, but right around this time, he sends his IS-2 backwards, even though, he could have, if he had rushed that thing forward, there would have been nothing I could have done to really prevent it from advancing. Half-Jack miraculously gets away, despite having critical engine damage.
Yeah, the American player's starting to try to take some territory back. I had knocked out all of his vehicles earlier. He's just now getting out a Jackson, but that's all he has right now. He lost the Wolverine, lost the utility car, lost the AA half-track, so that really put me in a good position to take back the initiative.
Oh, man. Again. He has. If you look at his...
And here's Darkfire sliding, a humble gentleman. I'll say it for him, because he's too humble to say it himself.
Of course. I'm actually looking at the American player's viewpoint, and he's actually got two demo charges set up. You can actually see where they are. But the IS-2 decides to make a push here, and I, you know, I feel like I'm a broken record here, but once again, Panzer Tactician coming in to save the day. He tries to fire, you know, attack ground at it, but it's insufficient to stop the problem. And once again, you know, he keeps bleeding my troops with his snipers, with his infantry, but with this half-track, I'm able to reinforce my troops. And at Vet 2 and 3, the... you know, their units get up, they can get closer, and you can reinforce from a further distance with the half track. So I kind of forgot what I was gonna say there for a second. I was distracted because for some reason it wouldn't switch to my viewpoint. But anyway, yeah, really really bad micro with this Jackson here. Lets it get fousted, and takes critical engine damage from the look of it.
Yeah, I would have just backed off. Hop the crew out and repair it, because it's really not at low health at all. I wouldn't have taken it very long to get that crit fixed, even without the crit fix ability.
Yeah, and the other thing is about that, like, Jackson's, you typically, like, I always keep my Jackson's out of sight.
Right.
from the enemy. It's very much like an ambush unit. But anyway, here's kind of the game-changing engagement here at this field point again. Like I said, almost the entire match took place in this field point, I think, as well as in the fields in the west, of course, at that munitions point, which is about what you would, you know, probably expect from what a COH match is supposed to look like. Anyway, kind of a weird thing here. He just kind of sits his IS-2 right in front of my pack, and I actually get, like, two hits into it, take out about a third of its health. And it's right at this moment, I've got a third Panzer IV on the way, and Conquistador's got out his Tiger. And
thank God.
Yeah. Now, what I would have done, I think, with my conscripts in this situation, I probably would have tried to recrew, like, my pack, because he wipes it twice, but...
Yeah, here comes the pincer maneuver. Woo!
But yeah, we're able to pincer this IS-2. And once again, Panzer Tactician, hide that almost dead Panzer IV from enemy eyes. So now they can't kill it. It'll get away and I'll fix it. It really is an amazing ability, I think. Definitely perhaps like underrated. But then again, I believe it's Spearhead Doctrine gets a Tiger and Panzer Tactician, which probably makes it, you know, one of the best, definitely, commanders available to Wehrmacht at the moment in the current meta. And yeah, from this point onward, we're basically just sweeping them out. We've taken out the IS-2. All the Soviet player has left at this point is a T-70, and he got his own half-track, but it kind of just sat at his base the whole match, along with the snipers. They're, yeah, and at this point, I believe, does he drop here?
It was shortly after the IS-2 was destroyed, so yeah, it should be soon.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert, he drops.
Yeah. Yeah, there we go. He drops at 26 minutes. And I mean, yeah, the match basically is lost at this point. I've got three Panzer IVs under my command.
And I've got a Panzer IV and a Tiger.
and it's not really something that they could have afforded to beat. Now, oddly enough, the American player actually has a Jackson left, but watch this maneuver here. I don't know if this was a miss micro or if this was intentional. He was trying to flank or what, but sends in his Jackson. It immediately dies to.
Yeah, know. He just like rushes it right into a Tiger and two Panzer IVs.
Yeah, and then
that was a bad strategic move.
Yeah, rushes his Sherman back to his base, and at this point he basically just completely gives up. And then Chameleon is a bad sport about it all. I'm guessing that English isn't his first language. But basically
he's gay to e in an onen guy.
Yeah.
I don't even know.
Basically he's saying like, you know, this game is nonsense.
This game is a nonsense.
Yeah, kind of almost like an Italian feel to it, but you know, we were trying to be, you know, courteous to them, like, midway through the game, because I was really having a lot of fun in this match, and I think this match could really have gone either way, but now, he's just raging that the Germans are OP, as our Panzer IVs ravaged.
If you ask me, the reason they lost is because they kept throwing all their vehicles away, and we never lost any.
Exactly. And you could construe that to Wehrmacht being OP, but really, I think that they weren't aggressive enough. They let me get away with smoking every time one of my vehicles was dead.
And in my case, it's just because the American player just left his vehicles right in front of my AT guns or my Panzer IV. He didn't micro them very well to keep them alive. He kind of just sat glass cannon units in front of my Panzer IVs, expecting them to tank shots and win, and it just didn't work.
Yeah, from here, it's... And from here, it's basically just a stomp. He tries to take back the VPs, and he thinks he'll win that way, while he keeps raging about the balance. But one thing I wonder is, if he had spent his munitions on bazookas instead of like demolition charges, because those are expensive, I wonder how much differently this battle might have gone on the Western Front here. Cleaning up these AT guns, not really a problem for a couple of Panzer IVs, though they do a lot of damage to Conquistador's Tiger. Don't underestimate those U.S. AT guns. They can inflict a serious amount of hurt on tanks, which is something I would say to any Allied player. If the Axis holds like a fuel point for as long as you do. Like if the map is evenly split, you always want to get out early AT and have something to deal with tanks, because tanks are going to come at some point.
That's true for both sides, but especially when you're allies, because Panzer IVs are tough.
Yeah, that's the thing. Panzer IVs can kind of handle themselves, but I think for the U.S., having an AT gun is really crucial.
Gardening absurd. Yeah. Do you see the number of Tanakh?
Relic's censoring always cracks me up.
It's Commelty imbecile.
Yeah, definitely not his first language there. The conceptor of Company of Heroes 2 must have a mental problem. and this is the thing, right? Like, if you lose a match, I don't think you necessarily want to, like, make an ass out of yourself, like, alongside it. Because the thing is, we went on the rest of the night to play a couple more matches as allies, and went 4-for-4 that night. So we were... needless to say, I think honestly, in the current meta, the factions are probably more balanced than they've ever been, with maybe a slight advantage.
No, we're just OP.
we're just OP. But
even if we play like any faction, it doesn't matter. Whatever we play is OP.
Yeah, maybe we're just good, but I think that like right now, I think the game is really balanced the way it is, with probably a slight advantage to Axis in team games because they're able to take more fuel, but. Yeah, from this point onward, we're just cleaning up. He doesn't draw from the game. That's another thing. If you're losing, this badly, I don't know if it's really like you know polite of you to stay in the match for much longer.
Like for the sole purpose of bitching too. Like not even to try and come back.
Oh yeah.
I mean, not that I mind, you know, bending him over backwards, but you know, it is kind of bad manners.
Oh yeah, it's definitely. Unsportsmanlike conduct, shall we say.
You know them, OP.
Yeah.
It's funny, because we're normally allied players. Most of our matches are allies.
Yeah, it's funny. I'm probably going to end up establishing myself as an Axis player by uploading this as my first replay ever to my channel.
But, funny.
But honestly, we play allies most of the time. But the thing is, I feel like allied replays can sometimes be really boring, because you win the match... A lot of the times, allied matches are won in the first 10 minutes of the game, depending on how much territory you take.
Yeah, especially if you're the U.S.
U.S. especially, if you don't take those like if you don't take the map in those first 10 minutes, it's just you lose like automatically.
It's basically instant lose.
Yeah, the Soviets I will say are a lot better for team games for that.
Absolutely.
And honestly, I'm just kind of trying to stimulate discussion while we finish off his base and see. He keeps raging. But yeah.
It's a Commelty imbecile. Gah.
and he accuses us of like you know, basically like tech rushing and stuff. And I'm like, I built a half track, you know, I wasn't trying to get a Panzer IV out particularly early.
I think he meant base rushing.
Oh,
not
yeah.
Tech rushing.
Oh,
I would hardly call 32 minutes when they have no army base rushing, but, you know, whatever.
Yeah, especially when they won't surrender. I just really didn't want to, like, wait any longer for this match. He's actually been out of troops for, like, a couple of minutes now, and
he literally has zero population.
And he's floating almost 1,700 manpower. I'm floating like 900, but that's because my pop's almost full, and I don't really need to build any more units at this point. And if I did, I probably would have just built another Panzer IV, to be honest. I think as Wehrmacht, you can definitely get away with only building Panzer IVs if you're fighting a U.S. army. Like, in a 2v2, if they're both U.S., you can probably get away with just building Panzer IVs. They don't really have any, like, solid counters. Well, if they get enough Jacksons out and you micro, right? But that's the thing about COH, you know, it's definitely a micro-based game, and a lot of the times the engagements just come down to whether or not you manage to outplay them. But
I like it so much compared to other RTSs like StarCraft. Obviously, micro is an important part of other games. I just feel like COH is basically all about micro, whereas StarCraft is very...
Right. I'm going to take a look here quickly. So here we go. Most valuable unit, Panzer IV, dealing roughly, you know, just over 10,000 damage, taking almost as much.
My Panzer IV, also my most valuable unit. God bless Panzer IVs.
Indeed. Panzer IVs are a very strong unit. And a lot of people actually whine about them being overpowered. I personally don't think they're overpowered. They're actually pretty easy to take out.
I don't think so either. And like we said, we're normally ally players, and I don't think Panzer IVs are overpowered. If you ask me, they actually keep getting the short end of the stick when it comes to patch notes, because allies, medium tanks have been buffed quite a few times, whereas the Panzer IVs more or less stayed where it's been, actually receiving nerfs a long time ago. So actually, I think it's fine where it is, to be honest.
Yeah, and one thing I think is really interesting is in the damage screen, you could see that like the damage numbers were almost even. But the thing is, this is definitely how I like to play anyway. I use my my tanks as, you know, like tanks in like the RPG sense, to run up, kind of soak up some damage before the infantry come in to clean it up. You know, obviously you have to be careful when you do that. But the thing is, sometimes you actually end up like your enemies will end up doing more damage to you that way. Just because, like, vehicle damage is so much higher than infantry damage, just because of the amount of health that units actually have.
And the thing is with tanks versus infantry is if you don't destroy the tank and it gets repaired, all that damage is for nothing, really, except for, like, taking it out of the game for a couple minutes to repair it, whereas with infantry you have to spend manpower to reinforce.
Exactly, which is why I think light vehicle micro is a really good skill to have, as any faction, to be completely honest. Ober Commando, you definitely want to, if you want to go mech truck, get that flak track. That is a very strong unit. Americans, the flak half track, very strong unit. Wehrmacht, ironically, has probably, like, arguably the weakest light vehicles available, and yet I was able to make that half-track work, just because I think half-tracks are, in this game and in the first game, half-tracks were just really strong. But
and not only for their offensive capability, but also just for the merit of being able to reinforce with them is so nice to have as a utility.
Yeah, absolutely. And but anyway, GG, and thank you for watching. If you want to see more replays like this in the future, make sure to like, comment, and potentially subscribe. And there will be more as I'm getting back into the Company of Heroes 2 online. So thank you for watching, and see you next time.